Good morning, Aloha. It is Dallas Onaveros here joining you on our Instagram Live for Take 2. We're actually in between commercial breaks right now. We're at the Honolulu Harbor talking about those containers off the coast of Hilo, but we're taking a little break right now from all of that, and we're going to have a really special guest. His name is the Aloha Junkman. You might have seen his work on social media, and if you've been watching Take 2, we've covered him and his story in the past. It's a really great group who's really just cleaning up the community for whatever reason it may be, whether you just want to get rid of things in out of your own home, whether you want a new start, whether you're helping family out or friends who have homes out here in Hawaii who just need a new space. So that's where the Aloha Junkman comes in. But something that is happening this morning is a cleanup over in Kailua. So that's why the Aloha Junkman is going to join us here live. I'm just waiting for him to jump on here. So I could just, oh, there he is. Yeah, I love it. So let's go on. Good morning, everyone. Aloha. Good morning. Good morning. Hey, what's up, man? How's it going?
Hey, man. How you doing?
Good morning. Aloha. How's everything?
Good morning. We're good, man. We're out here. Let me turn my, I don't know how to turn it around, but we're out here on Kapa'a Quarry Road.
Okay.
Anybody that lives in Kailua is well aware of this dumping site right around the corner from the dump where you can dump stuff for free, but people don't make it there for some reason and dump it on the side of the road. So when we have a slow day or if we have a day when we can schedule it in, sometimes this is just kind of, there's no more room to dump. And so we want to clean out all the junk, and it's just something that we're doing from our heart.
Absolutely. And I was telling a little bit about your story and about the Aloha Junkman. You've been on here for Take 2 with us, but for people who don't know, a little bit about why you do what you do and the whole purpose behind it, go ahead and share with us.
Yeah, so I never inspired to be a junk man when I was a kid, man, but my journey that God had me on led me here, man. And we love what we do. And so a lot of what we do is we want to give back to the community in a way to recycle a lot of the stuff that we come across, because it's called junk removal, but a lot of the stuff that you come across is not actually junk. So we work with local nonprofits, ministries, individuals. People make orders and we find the stuff the next couple days coming up. And it's incredible how much waste we're able to reduce by being charitable. We go to Salvation Army. Sometimes we'll go to Goodwill, but we actually have a lot of people that during COVID have actually taken our stuff because these guys weren't even receiving stuff, but just comes through making relationships over time, being in the business and finding people that need what we come across.
And you know, that's such a good point, and I want to ask you about that in just a bit right here. But how amazing is it, you know, to have the purpose of your work recycle in itself, you know? Like, not only are you cleaning up the community, but you're giving back as well. Just the whole purpose of recycling, it's all in a cycle right here. What's up, everyone? Aloha.
Yeah.
You have an amazing team, by the way.
Yeah, they're in their yellow vest, and we have some kids from the community that are taking part in this cleanup today. Man, we love it, dude. I'm telling you, we have stories, tons of stories of where we're able to help people with the stuff that we come across, or even you know, just some of the work that we do. People are so blessed when we leave, because some of these situations are so overwhelming that people just can't get past how much stuff they got, or, you know, maybe a deceased relative's house is full of stuff and they need to sell it, or maybe they may need to sell it just to take care of the elderly, you know, person that they're there helping. And we come in and, you know, it looks like a breeze for us when we do what we do and we leave. And, but man, this thing is what we do is from the heart, man. We really love what we do. People comment a lot of times about the smile on our faces while we're in a stinky a stinky situation or moving heavy furniture and stuff, but I'm telling you, we are blessed every day with how we get to help folks.
Oh yeah. In a way it kind of feels like treasure hunting.
Oh bro, it is, man. Last week I was in a house and I was cleaning, we were cleaning out the garage and we were cleaning out like the closet in the garage. This is outside. And bunch of old dusty boxes and paint cans. I found a signed Muhammad Ali boxing glove.
What?
Yes.
Okay, so where is that at?
So we're honest, man. We're integral. So obviously I went to the customer. I don't think that he knew that it was in there. I don't know if his wife stuffed it in there or they misplaced it. So he was very thankful that I brought it to him. And so I didn't get to keep that. That's one of the treasures that I didn't get to keep. But you know what? I sleep good at night. I have peace because of how we operate. And so we gave it back to him and he was stoked. But that's probably one of the craziest things I've ever found.
And super recent too, just last week.
Yeah, it was like 2 weeks ago. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Just, I mean, coming across that, wow, that is amazing. Now, yeah. I only have a couple of minutes here. I know you're out on the scene, but really quickly, how can people contact you and where can they find you right now if they live in the Kailua area?
Yeah, so we're on Instagram. It's Aloha Junkman. And that's a place that you can see a lot of our content. We do a lot of videos, we do a lot of pictures of what we're doing. And then our phone number is 808-940-0809, or you can see us online at alohajumpman.com.
Perfect. And one thing I want to ask you before I let you go is, you mentioned about how the coronavirus has kind of, you know, changed the way you work and people are now asking, you know, for different donations in this time of, you know, hardship. Any way that people can get in hold to you if they need any appliances or furniture, or maybe they just need to clean out the area. Besides your Instagram, have you been getting a lot of those requests lately?
Haven't got a lot of requests, but something that we want to do is we want to influence the industry. Obviously, we have people out here that are competing against us in the industry. Like, I want everybody to do this, and so. You know, I wouldn't say that we have an overload of stuff. We don't always find good stuff. So normally a lot of the stuff that we get is already spoken for, but if somebody contacts us and says that they're looking for something, we'll do our best to find it for them, you know, 'cause first come, first serve kind of thing, man. But I would encourage any of the other guys out there doing what we're doing, take the extra time to set it aside to donate to someone. Because it's a lot easier for me to hit that button on the dump truck and dump it in the dump. It takes us time to do this. Sometimes we have to drive across the island to drop it off somewhere or whatever. But this is part of our heart. It's part of our vision, is to reuse this stuff and to recycle the stuff that we come across and to bless other people with it. Because we're being stewards of this island. You know what I mean? And so if I just throw more in the dump that could go and bless someone else, like, I'm not doing my part.
Well, Matt, you just said it in the best ways that we know that Aloha Junkman really represents and stands an example. Unfortunately, I do have to go live in just a bit right here. So I want to thank you just for jumping on here. Of course, we want to have you again on here and just sharing more of your story and giving you an update.
Yeah, no problem, man. Take care, Matt. Hey, bless you, Dallas. Thanks for having me, man. See ya.
Aloha.
Aloha. Bye.